Okay guys, so I'm back again with another video. This time I'm going over kind of some things that I just picked up for the greyhound, the former racing greyhound that I just picked out actually 2 weeks ago. She's a foster right now and I won't be getting her until Friday, which I'm super excited about. I cannot wait. Her name is Penelope and I will just kind of get into her in this video and kind of show you the things I picked up for her. So first off, I have gone to PetSmart and got most of the stuff is from PetSmart and Walmart, which is kind of an informative thing for you. So the collar is from PetSmart, and same with the name tag. This is one of the martingale collars. They sell at PetSmart. This was $6. No, I'm sorry. This was $11. And it's not the specific type of martingale that you're supposed to get for greyhounds. Greyhounds need the much thicker ones. And then it's also got more of a supportive, like buckle, smaller buckle and more supportive and stuff just for them because they got like little necks and tiny little heads. And hopefully they don't really, the collars don't come off as easily. So this one I'm hoping will do the trick just for now until I have time to pick out a really nice one online. The other thing I picked up at PetSmart was this Martha Stewart leash. This was on sale for $3, which was fantastic. It wasn't exactly what I was looking for. I do put really like other leashes just because I feel like, I don't know, I just don't like the way they feel. I feel like they work a little better. I don't know, maybe that's just me. But this would be the trick for now, as this was only $3. So that was kind of a steal, especially because it's my best story. I also got at Walmart a coat, since it's still February, March, basically. It's still winter. So I picked up a coat at Walmart. This was on sale for $5. It's the extra, extra large. I don't remember the brand. I don't think it had a brand on the tag. It was just sitting like this heap of sale bin stuff for animals and pets at Walmart. So this is kind of reversible-ish, not really, but it's got pink camel on the inside, and then it's like the water-resistant top covering. So for now, this will work until, again, I have money and time to go online and pick up an actual greyhound coat, just because greyhound coats are very expensive, because people usually get the ones that cover their legs, but full-blown substance. And that's what I want, so I'll wait until I have time and money to kind of get that. Some other things I have are some dental chews, as greyhounds have really bad teeth. I figure I would make sure I get something that's going to kind of help get rid of the plaque and tartar on her teeth. And these were, how much were these? I think these were $5 or $6 at Walmart. Normally I wouldn't get the Purina dental sticks. I don't really like Purina as a brand. I feel like a lot of their stuff is really like cheaply made and not very healthy for animals. So after she's done with these, I'm actually planning on making dental type dog treats. I just have to kind of come up with a good recipe and things that I feel like would be okay for her. And then I also picked up some other treats, these nudgies. I have used before, at least my parents have used before for their dogs, and they seem to be pretty good. My mom is very good about having good quality dog treats and dog food and stuff for all of their animals. So kind of whatever she uses, I will copy and kind of use as well. And these were $3, no, $4 I believe, at Walmart. I also got some kids' toothbrushes at Walmart. There's two of them, it's a double pack, this one's about $2, $2 or $3. I got two of them because I'm planning on using one for my kitty and then one for Penelope. I'm waiting on the dental toothpaste until I actually go to the vet clinic, just because I feel like a lot of pet stores, I've noticed that some of the ingredients in their toothpaste are not acceptable for animals. One pet store in particular, a few years ago when I was in living in Madison, Wisconsin, I noticed that there was a pet store that carried a toothpaste that had xylitol in it, which is poisonous for animals. So that's kind of steered me away from getting like the stuff at the pet store, just because it's not usually not good quality. You really have to be careful with what's in the products you're buying, just because fillers, they use whatever they can get a hold of that's cheap and should work. So I don't know, I'm just really cautious about that. I don't want to cause any problems to the animals or whatever. So I also picked up some nail trimmers because I feel like it's a good idea for me to do that kind of stuff here instead of having to pay anywhere from $10 to $20 on a nail trim, when greyhounds are actually like very, very well trained for that kind of thing. They're used to being handled and stuff, so it shouldn't be too hard for me to do a simple nail trim on my own. If so, I'll kind of come up with something, we'll see. I also have a mitten or glove brush. This I picked up on Groupon. I don't know if I mentioned, these were $9. This I picked up on Groupon. I think this was around $9 as well. This is able to be used in the bath as well as outside of the bath. And the reason I got this is just because greyhounds have skin similar to human skin, where it'll like scratch and break very easily. So I wanted something that requires like less tension or scraping and things when it comes to brushing. So these are really soft, like silicone little nubs for brushing, so this should be okay. I also picked this out because my cat sheds like nothing that I've ever experienced before. So this is good for him. I can just kind of give him a massage by brushing him, and he doesn't seem bothered by it, so that's always nice. I also have a basket of toys and things for Penelope. Most of these I have had for a long time at my parents' house. When I got home, I just kind of collected all the old toys and things that were at home. These are all like little things my mom has gotten me over the years. It's like little Valentine's Day gifts with like a box of chocolate or something. So I have a few little toys that she had given me over the years that I'm going to reuse as little dog toys. And I also picked up from Walmart this little sticky bone, and this was $2. At Walmart, I also got this Sumo, which is basically the same thing as a Kong, but much, much cheaper. This was only $6 in comparison to the $15 to $25, $29 you'd spend on a Kong toy. And it's this same material. Walmart, I also picked up a little rope toy. It might be too small, but it'll do the trick for now. This was about 94 cents, I believe. 94 cents, it's a good looking rope toy. It seems to be pretty strong. We'll see how well it holds up with her. Some other toys that I picked up at PetSmart. I found this adorable little monster. It's also a squeaker. And this thing is so cute. I'm hoping she does not destroy this, because I want this to be her favorite toy that she just carries around everywhere. It's really cute. I don't want to have to replace it. And then the last toy I have in here, I picked up at the grocery store. It's this cute little pig. It's got polka dots on his back. And it's really cute. It makes a cute noise. I'm probably going to regret it, but that's okay. My cat is terrified of it. And then this basket is a 31 bag that my parents actually had at their house, and I took it over the weekend while I was visiting. It goes really well with the decor of my apartment, and so I wanted like a cute little like toy bin. I didn't really want to use a basket, like a wicker basket, so this will work perfectly. I also picked up at Walmart this mat for dog food bowls and stuff. This was, how much was this? $8, I think? I can't remember exactly. I think it was one of the more expensive ones that they had there. And the reason why I picked this one out was just because it's a little bit thinner. It's not as big of a like rectangle, and it won't take up as much space, and it's really not an eyesore. And again, it's that gray, and my theme for my apartment is kind of more gray, blue, green kind of thing. So it'll go pretty well with the decor in my apartment as well. I also got some dog food bowls. I'm gonna pull them out. It's just the regular metal or like steel dog food bowls. These ones were $5. I can't remember the name of the pet store. store I got them at, but I should have gone to Walmart because they were $2 at Walmart and I could have saved a few bucks. Would have been nice. I also picked up at Walmart a 50-pound food bin for dogs. That was $21. And currently I have in the bin a bag of organic dog food that I found at PetSmart for $61. I do have a dog bed. The cat is currently sitting on it, so I'll probably insert pictures just to kind of show you what it looks like. And then I have a cage that has a dog cage lined dog bed with two blankets. The blankets were some fleece blankets they found at Walmart for $2. And then the dog bed was $19 at Walmart in the dog section. The cage I got from my parents, so that was free, which was great because they sell the exact same cage at Walmart for around $50, and then the same style at PetSmart for around $160. So I kind of really lucked out there. I think that's everything that I have for her. I'm kind of looking around to see if there's anything I missed. No, I think I got everything. So, I guess I will just kind of leave the video here and then continue once I get her so I can kind of show you guys what she looks like and maybe show you like training and things for her as well. So you guys can let me know what you're interested in seeing and then we'll go from there.